Could I have your attention, please? My name is Tommy Jacquette, and I'm the executive director of the 1972 Watt Summer Festival. And it's my pleasure to welcome you all here today to the first annual Wattstax 1972. And for those of you who attended the 1972 Watt Summer Festival, I'd just like to say to you, it was really black and beautiful this year, just like this audience. You owe that to yourself. Give yourself a big hand. I'm only going to be up here for a very few minutes because my job is to introduce someone that you all know and respect, and then to get back to the music. But I have to make one little comment.
Just a moment, everybody. We'd like to make an interruption here, if we possibly could. At this time, we'd like to present Tommy Jacquette, the executive director of the Watt Summer Festival, for his outstanding services. Let's give Tommy a big round of applause. Lay it on him. Tommy is the Watt Summer Festival. You know, throughout the history of the Watt Summer Festival, we've always had flack from different people and different authorities who felt like it shouldn't happen. But Tommy was the brother that we felt that had the drive and initiative and the heart to do what had to be done so we could make this kind of a situation possible. Let's give him another round of applause. Why don't we stand up and give Tommy a big round of hands? Stand up, everybody. Stand up and give it to Tommy Jacquette.
Thank you, Tony Rushen. Tony Rushen is the chairman of the board of the Watt Summer Festival. I like to say that if I've done anything of any worth and have achieved any degree of greatness, I owe it all to black people. Everything that I am because of black people. It is black people who inspire me to push on and struggle on for freedom and justice in America for all of us. Once we achieve that freedom and justice, then the world would be free and just. And now to bring on the Reverend Jesse Jackson.
Right on, give Tommy another great round of applause. This is a beautiful day. It is a new day. It is a day of black awareness. It is a day of black people taking care of black people's business. It is beautiful that the Stax Record Company has come out south to talk about liberation through music and lyrics. Stax Record Company is located in Memphis, Tennessee, on the banks of the Mississippi River, and has come to Los Angeles on the banks of the Pacific River, still talking about liberation. This is the one industry where, because of our gifts as singers and actors, we can produce and distribute and consume. Fortunately, in addition to that which Stax brings to this occasion, another company, the Sliss Brewers of Milwaukee, has joined in this venture. And I first want to introduce to you the black man who owns Stax, the black man responsible for the success of Black Moses, Brother Al Bell. Just come on out here and let the world know who you are. Also, we have another brother to introduce to you, representing the Sliss Breweries. For some years, he used to run up and down this field with his legs. Now he's out here running up and down this field with his brains, taking care of business, Brother Willie Davis. Come on, Brother Willie. It is important to announce to you today that in this relationship between Stax and Slits, it is not the old relationship of the outside domination. It is a relationship between the inside and the outside in participation. Last Thursday in Milwaukee, we signed a national agreement with SLITS, SLITS and Operation Push. We decided that SLITS owed us 300 jobs worth $5 million to Black America, that they had to retain a Black lawyer worth $60,000, that they had to advertise in the Black media, that they had to use Black insurance companies worth $15 million a year, that they had to use Black banks worth $11 million a year, that they had to use Black public relations firms worth $35,000 a year, that they had to use Black services worth $90,000 a year, that they had to use Black construction companies. The whole deal was Black America got $40 million out of a negotiation with SLITS Brewers. That is why they are here today. As the country preacher out of South Carolina, out south here in Laos, Mississippi, California, right on, we ain't had nothing worse in South Carolina for a governor than y'all got out here. Just changed the place, but the game is the same. Today, we are together. We are unified and on one accord. And whenever we come together, the news media come, the writers write, the cameras roll, the politicians look at us, because together we got power. Apart, we got powwow. That's just rapping. But when we are together, we got power, and we can make decisions. Today on this program, you will hear gospel and rhythm and blues and jazz. All those are just labels. We know that music is music. All of our people got a soul. Our experience determines the texture, the taste, and the sound of our soul. So what is Jimmy Jones singing, Somebody Bigger Than You and I? Or the Staple Singer singing Unclouded Day? Or Black Moses singing I Stand Accused? All of us are one people singing our music, popping our finger, and doing our thing. Let's give ourselves a great round of applause. Something new has happened in America. The government has not changed. Politics have not changed. But something has happened to the Black man in America. Nation time has come. We say that we may be in the slum, but the slum is not in us. We may be in prison, but the prison is not in us. In Watts, we have shifted from burn, baby, burn to learn, baby, learn. We have shifted from having a seizure about what the man got to season what we need. We have shifted from bed bugs and dog ticks to community control and politics. That is why we gather today to celebrate our homecoming and our own sense of somebody-ness. When we say nation time, what do we mean? It means that when dogs bite Black people in Birmingham, Black people bleed all over America. It means that when Black people cannot run in Rhodesia, Black people will not run from America. If white Rhodesia want to run in the Olympics, then white America can run in the Olympics and have a turtle race in Germany. That's all it will be without Black runners. And
That is why I challenge you now to stand together, raise your fists together, and engage in our national black litany. Do it with courage and determination. I am somebody. I am somebody. I may be poor, but I am somebody. I may be on welfare, but I am somebody. I may be unskilled, but I am somebody. I am black, beautiful, proud. I must be respected. I must be protected. I am God's child. What time is it? When we stand together, what time is it? When we say no more yes to boss, what time is it? What time is it? What time is it?